Hi everyone, my name is Leah Kopke and I'm a 3D motion design freelancer. In each one of these episodes, we go over another 3D modeling tool inside of Cinema 4D. And today's 3D modeling tool is called Fit Circle. So let's jump into Cinema 4D and show how this works. So here we are inside of Cinema 4D. The very first thing that I'm going to do is grab a sphere and I'll change our sphere to a hexahedron. You'll be able to see what that does more if I turn on lines with display. So now we have lines on. This is the standard. This is hexahedron. I'm going to increase our segments to 32. And that'll give us some more polygons to work with. The radius is fine. And I'm just going to make this editable by hitting this button here. You can also use the C hotkey. And once that is done, I'll go into polygon mode. This tool works in polygon mode, edge mode, and point mode. So you can work in either one. I'm just starting with polygon mode. And what I'll do here is I'll grab my brush selection right there. And if I want to increase the size of my brush selection, I can use the bracket keys. Left brackets makes it smaller, right brackets makes my selection larger. I'm going to select this area here, and then I'll make my brush a little bit smaller again so that I can select these corners. So, now what we're going to do once I have these all selected is we are going to change this into being a circle. So we actually, in polygon mode, we have our fit circle option right here. You can also find that in the command manager with shift C. The command manager is also up here and you can type in the name of the tool you'd like to use. So that's the second way you can find it. For right now, I'll just use the one over here. And what I'll do is I'll begin dragging my mouse. And you can see a circle already on our sphere. And you'll notice that this circle is flat. So it does that automatically, unless if you choose project to surface, then it will respect the curvature of that sphere there. So you have an option here, project to surface, or you can have it raised like so. You'll notice we have strength here. This is the strength of the tool. You have the option for roundness, how round the circle is. You can see we can go back and forth between this. You have the option of scale. You can scale the circle up and down. You can adjust its angle, and that will twist it a little bit. But you need to be careful with this one because it can cause some issues with your geometry if you twist it too far. But it's good to be aware of that. That's what that does. I'll change it back to 0. And I'll change the scale back to 100. We have these other options here, adjust inner points. If I turn this on, you'll notice that the inner points are adjusting and smoothing out a little bit more to the curvature of the circle. If I turn that off, it goes back to how it was. So you have the option of turning that on or keeping it off. We went over project to surface and what that does. Equal spacing right now is turned on. If I turn this off, the edges between each one of these points will no longer be equal. If I turn on equal spacing, it will force each one of these outer edges to be equal in length. So that's what that does. So the next option is called Select Outline. If I select this right here on our circle and we go into Edge Mode, you'll see that we have our outline selected. And that might be useful for modeling, like let's say you decide you'd like to extrude out the circle, you can do that. If you need to do that for some reason, you could really build this out. I'm going to hit undo, but just so that you're aware, that option is there in case if you want to keep that selection for modeling. You can also save your selection under the select drop-down menu, store selection, and it'll just save that edge selection for you. So if you ever want to click on it again, even if you click away, if you double click on that, you get your edge selection back. So that's how this tool works in polygon mode. And it's pretty powerful. I'm going to go ahead and hide our sphere because now we're going to drop in a cube. And I'm going to change our segments to 10 by 10 by 10. And we're going to show how this works in some other modes. I'll hit this button here again to make it editable. You can also use C, the hotkey. And what I'll do is I'll select now a group of edges. So I'm holding down shift and I'm going to select these ones along here. The more segments you have in your object, the more round this circle will be. So now I will go ahead and hit fit circle, and you can see it's still here even when we're in edge mode off to the side. I'll select fit circle, I'll hit apply, and we have a nice round circle. And you have the same options of adjust inner points, project to surface. You can still angle this if you'd like to, you just gotta be careful. Once you start seeing black polygons, you've gone too far. That means you're having an error and surfaces are intersecting. So just be careful about this. If you choose to use it, make sure that you avoid having any twisting happening. But that is basically how that works. Real-time update just means you'll see your changes in real-time as you adjust these settings here. I always keep that on. Apply will apply your settings to whatever you have selected. New transform will apply your settings you used the last time, again, to a new group of polygons if you select this. Moving on to over here, I'm going to go into point mode. I have visible only selected so that when I select points, I'm not selecting ones on the other side of the model. I'm only selecting ones visible to my current camera view. So now I'll go into rectangle selection here. I'll select these points, making sure I have visible only turned on. When I switched it to rectangle selection, it turned off. So I need to turn that on again. I'll do it one more time just to make sure. None are selected on the back, that's good. And then we have fit circle again right here. We'll just select this and we'll make a circle here. And you can see when I am moving my mouse back and forth, we're actually affecting the scale. So you have some control here over how large your circle is when you initially make that circle. And this would be really difficult to do otherwise, so it's a really handy tool to have available. And you can see that it also saved our edges there, even when we do that from point mode. There's one more thing that I'd like to show you with polygon mode. I'm holding down shift and just going to select these around the cube. And now that we've done that, I can grab my fit circle again and we can create a ring. So it can be really useful for modeling. We can extrude this out. We can make all kinds of interesting shapes with this. This could be for Mario. It could be one of those tubes that Mario jumps into. Going to use ML to create a line there. ML creates a polygon loop, so I created a polygon loop there. We went over that in a previous tutorial. I'll use UL now to select this loop, and I'll use T, the hotkey for transform, and I'll hold down control while I scale this. And while it's scaling, it'll also extrude it out. And then if I go ahead and decide I'm going to turn this whole object around 90 degrees, now we have a nice tunnel for Mario to jump into. That pretty much wraps up our tutorial today for Fit Circle. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did and you want to learn more 3D modeling tools, I come out with a new one each week, and you'll be notified if you hit like or subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. And if you make anything using any of the tips from these tutorials, you can share it with me on Instagram by using my handle at Leah Kopke. Hope to see some of your beautiful 3D modeling, and I'll see you on the next tutorial.